This is a fun one and probably one of the most important videos of this series, setting up your waterfall. In this video, we'll cover how to set up a basic waterfall to start monetizing your apps. Waterfalls are configured at the ad unit level. Both bidding and traditional networks compete by the highest CPM to serve an impression. This competition maximizes your overall revenue, ensuring you're being paid the most money for each ad opportunity, and that is the magic of a unified auction. Max waterfalls are easy to set up and completely automated, but allow for more controls to fit advanced needs when needed. So the first step is to navigate to your ad unit where you want to set up the waterfall. So as a refresher, you will click the little Max button in the left nav, and then you'll click Ad Units, and you'll end up here, which is your main ad unit page. Then you'll click on the ad unit that you want to start monetizing. So you'll scroll down to the waterfall section, and you'll see default waterfall. The default waterfall is your primary waterfall for monetization. Waterfall management is automated through a combination of in-app bidding and CPM updating. Only enable networks that you've successfully integrated the SDK and connected to Max. So the first step is setting up your bidding networks. You'll see that App11 demand is enabled by default, so you can start monetizing right away with these. You don't have to take any action. As a reminder, App11 demand consists of the App11 network, which is called App Discovery, and the App11 Exchange, which is our real-time bidding exchange, which is exclusive to Max full platform publishers. So to set up your networks, it's as simple as clicking the dropdown, turning the network status to on, and dropping in your placement ID, and you're all done with your bidding networks. With some network bidders, you can auto-create network apps and placements directly in the Max UI by just adding your credentials. With this feature, you don't have to go back and forth between the Max UI and the network's UI. You can create the new app and placements right within Max, and all the IDs are populated within Max for you. For example, if we click on Pangle, you'll see this green box. It allows you to kick this process off. So you click here. I already added my Pangle credentials, so you just fill out the required information here, and then you can pull in your app and placement IDs and hit submit. Another cool feature is the app ID validation, which validates the same app ID as being used for a network within an ad unit waterfall or across multiple ad unit waterfalls. By having different IDs, this would cause initialization issues on the SDK side. For example, if you have Yahoo in your default waterfall and you drop in a site ID, and then you create a new waterfall that may be targeting users who aren't passing device ID and you want to change the ad experience for those users, you have that option. But if you accidentally put in another site ID, Max will flag this to you and not allow you to save the ad unit and throw you an error. So it just saves you time and helps you make sure that you're launching and monetizing in the right way. So once you're done setting up your bidding networks, you'll want to go down to your other networks or your non-bidding networks or traditional networks, whatever you want to call it. And the process of enabling a traditional network is the same as almost the same as a bidding network. You want to hit the drop down, you want to turn the toggle, the status toggle to on, and drop in the required IDs. And then you can set your CPM price and country targeting if applicable. So coming back to the CPM price, your CPM price should mirror the historical CPM or price floor set on the network side. After connecting your network, auto CPM will activate within a day or two to sync the actual eCPM the network is paying you. So it's very important not to put an arbitrary number here. It should match what your networks are paying you. And then within a day, auto CPM will kick in and this box will turn gray, and that's how you know that auto CPM is working. If you have multiple network IDs, you can click the add a new ad unit feature, and it will, and then you can add as many IDs as you need to. You can, lots of publishers use this to set up geo-targeting if they want to set certain price floors for different countries or sets of countries. Be careful with setting too many lines because some networks have restrictions on how many times they can call you with a single ad request. AdMob, for example, at this time of this video, they only allow you to call them three times with an ad request. So it's best to just check with your networks to see what their restrictions are as you're building your waterfall. If you have any direct sold campaigns, you can set them up within, you would come here and you would click direct sold, build the campaign, and then it would show here. And if you have any custom networks that you've created on the networks page, you would also see an option to activate them here. After you're done adding all of your networks, you can hit save. And if there is an error, AppLovin will tell you what you need to fix. I just have to remove this empty placement. Let's save again. Now the ad unit is saved. Another really interesting feature to save you time is the ability to clone waterfalls. So I have this cat game here, and I might want to duplicate the same waterfall I was running in my demo app here. So to do so, I would go clone existing waterfall, and then I would choose the waterfall that I want to clone. So it was my demo app interstitial. I want to copy over all the network placement IDs, and I will clone the waterfall. So now you can see all the networks I had set up on the demo app interstitial are now showing here. So let's see if my IDs came over. They did. You'll still want to make sure that you, only specific IDs are transferred over. So you just want to make sure you do a sweep and add in new IDs. And when you're cloning a waterfall, you know, it's the best practice not to use the same IDs because it would mess up your reporting. So just make sure that when you're cloning that you're updating all the IDs to be unique to that new ad unit. We covered this in the ad units video, but just as a refresher, frequency capping, because this is an interstitial unit, you have the option to dynamically control the frequency capping for this ad format. You do not have to do it if you do not want to, or you can control it from the client side. Additionally, bid floor allows you to set a bid price, a price floor to say, I don't want to receive ads from any partner, network, you know, direct sold, whoever, that is less than whatever the value you set is here. Use this option with caution because it will negatively affect your fill if you're cutting out the competition by setting a price floor here. So once you're done, you hit save. I'm not gonna save this one because it's asking me to fill out these fields, but just wanted to show you this feature. The last piece to setting up your waterfall I want to show you is being able to visualize your waterfall. So we're back in the original demo app interstitial where we initially built our waterfall. And we want to click on these three dots and you can see preview your waterfall or create an A-B test. We'll cover A-B testing in another video in the series. But to preview your waterfall to see what happens when an ad request comes in and hits this waterfall, you just click preview ad unit. And so you can see all the networks you set up with the price floors. And these are the folks that are participating in the unified auction. When an ad request comes, all the bidding networks bid in real time simultaneously. Whoever has fill will submit a bid price, and that bid price will be compared to any one of the traditional networks that have fill. Whoever has the highest CPM will win the unified auction and serve an impression. We covered this at the beginning of this video, but sometimes it's helpful to see exactly how the waterfall is looking. This is the first part of setting up your waterfall in this series. Check out setting up your waterfall part 2 to see how to build custom waterfalls and get access to more advanced features.